The following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Litchfield. I'm your host, John Latsha. Thank you. Thank you very much. All right. We're here at Studio One here on LCTV on Charles Bancroft Highway here in Litchfield, New Hampshire. Thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate it. It's been a while since I've done a show. We've done a couple of shows over the course of the last few months. One was a sand sculpture show that we did at Hampton Beach. I really enjoyed that. I hope everybody at home enjoyed that as well. Some great sculptures. I'm still amazed at how detailed the sculptures are. It's really amazing what great work these people can really do. I invite everybody to please, if you have a few moments next year around the beginning of June, come down and take a look at those sand sculptures. It's really a great sight to see. And also we had the blueberry show over at DeRocher Farm. I hope everybody enjoyed that as well. I met Ray DeRocher and Jen and Bob Marr over there. Had a great time over there. But the only problem is that, you know, when we got there, I was a little disappointed because I was expecting them to give me a t-shirt. Right? This is what I was expecting them to do. Now take a look at this, all right? Take a look at this. I'm standing there with Bob and Jen Meyer over here, okay? Do I look happy? Do I look excited to be there? The only thing that I'm thinking about is why didn't they give me and Tony a t-shirt, all right? Okay, great. All right, hey, you know something? We're moving up in the ranks here. Now we have actually business cards here at Litchfield Community Television. Take a look at that, huh? Wow, we're really moving up in the ranks here. In fact, I'm going to give some to my audience over here. Here you go. Please grab every single one of them over here. Don't fight all of them, okay? Okay, you lady, I'm sorry. Why did you have to step on the lady's hand over there? Jeez, I mean, come on, okay? All right. Hey, if you see one of these cards here, we're going to try to distribute them throughout the town of Litchfield. You might see some at Town Hall. You might see some at the library. Please pick some of these up and distribute them to your friends. Maybe some of your friends have a show in mind that they would like to come here on LCTV to do. Maybe somebody has a talent. So please, you see these cards around town, please give them to all your family and friends. I really appreciate it here. Thank you very much. All right. Okay, I understand that Pastor Lori Wiley from the Presbyterian Church is going to be retiring. I just hope that she would continue to do her shows over here, but I guess she's not going to be doing them anymore. Maybe she can tell the new pastor to come over here and do some shows in the future, hopefully. I really wish Pastor Lori the best of luck in the future. And from what I understand, as soon as they find another pastor to take her place, she will be retiring. Could be a few months, could be a few years, who knows. But seriously, best of luck to Pastor Lori Wiley. I watched her shows on LCTV. And learned a lot from a lot of her shows, and I really, really appreciate her spending the time here, giving us some shows here on Litchfield Community Television. Hey, is anybody interested in a car? I saw one in Merrimack. It's been sitting there for quite some time. Tony's going to put that picture up on the screen there, okay? It's just a little damaged on the right-hand side, as you can see. In fact, it's wiped out on the whole right side of this car, all right? That's why it's been sitting there so long, but I just thought I would be nosy, okay, because that's the kind of person that I am here. I'm trying to help this guy out to try to sell this car, okay? It's right on Daniel Webster Highway, okay, right next to the mobile station. The mobile station's there in Walgreens, all right? So if anybody's interested in this car, just go right down Route 3 in Merrimack, and there it is right on the left-hand side, covered by a bunch of weeds and bushes right now, because it's been sitting there for so long, all right? I don't know what's got into this guy's mind that he can actually sell this car. Maybe he's thinking somebody wants the parts to it. I don't know, but it's kind of embarrassing with a for sale sign on it with this south side of the car wiped out. I mean, sure. Hey, the Campbell High School graduation ceremony, I know it was a couple of months previous in June, but Tony's going to put this up here. Take a look at this woman in the right-hand corner over here, okay? She's actually blowing bubbles from bubble gum, okay? During a graduation ceremony. Can you believe it? Doesn't she know that we have a LCTV camera stationed all around that podium? And here she is blowing bubbles? I can't even believe this woman. And then take a look at this other woman. Tony, put that up on the screen so we all can see it at home. Here she is. She's grabbing the principal, okay, the head of the whole Campbell High School. She's grabbing him. She's telling him, look, I want you to get out of the way, okay, because my daughter's going to be coming up soon to get her diploma, and I'm going to give it to her, okay? You over there, and you stay over there. You get away from here. I'm in charge here, okay? And there she goes. But the problem is what if everybody else wanted to do that, huh? I'm sure that everybody else would like to do that. Does she think that she's special by doing this? Huh? Does she think she's special? Huh? This woman? She must think she's special because she just basically told the principal of Campbell High School off. I'm not lying. She just grabbed him and pushed him out of the way. All right? I mean, Tony's over there laughing too on this one. Oh, boy. I think I've been away from this desk for too long. I think I'm starting to go, oh, boy. All right. The weather has been pretty good lately. We've got a lot of rain and stuff lately. But Tony's going to put this up. Here's me mowing my lawn in my yard, okay? Here's me coming down the cliff, as you can see, holding on to dear life with the riding lawnmower. Now I'm going over towards this edge of the yard, making a turn back towards you now, okay? Now I'm going to be taking a left-hand turn. Now look at all the dust and everything kicking up all over the place. You people with nice plush green lawns, I envy you, okay? Because every time I have to mow my lawn, I have to have a mask on, I have to have safety glasses, all right? And I have to hang on for dear life onto this mower. As you can see, you know, Tony's going to put it up again to show you one more time, okay? You can see, man, I have to lean on one side of the mower so it doesn't flip over while I'm trying to drive it. I mean, how many of you people actually have to do that while you're mowing your lawn? All right? I mean, I don't know what this guy was thinking of when he built my house on top of a cliff. I mean, and guess what? I was stupid enough to buy it, all right? I was stupid enough to buy it. Oh, boy, okay. Okay, let's talk about Kevin Lynch. Why not? I mean, this show is called, as you can see up here, In Litchfield, okay? So if I would be remiss if I didn't mention anything about Kevin Lynch, all right? And remember the article, Tony putting that up on the screen over there? The article, I mean, they had to make it in red on the front page of the Hudson Litchfield News. I mean, it looked like a blood, you know, so everybody would just, the blood color, so everybody would just go right to that article and check it out. But, we really weren't kidding when we said that Kevin was in the doghouse. I mean, take a look at that. I mean, geez, see, we really weren't kidding when he was in the doghouse. I mean, from what I understand, when I watched the Board of Selectmen meeting, is that Kevin was transferred from Town Hall over to the fire station, and he was under the fire chief's Frank Fritzl. He was under, actually Frank Fritzl was his boss over there now. But I, from what I heard, is that these two don't get along together to begin with, all right? And so they, you know, I hate to say it, but I mean, I don't know why they put these two together when they know that there was gonna be a problem, all right? Now two people at the Board of Selectmen meeting spoke really highly about Kevin Lynch to the Board of Selectmen. Ray Peoples and John Bryant, all right? Take a look.
Raymond Peoples, 205 Charles Bancroft Highway, Litchfield, New Hampshire. I don't expect you guys to say one word because this is a personnel issue. I'm merely here to make a statement. I know I'm considered a troublemaker and a rabble-rouser, but I'll tell you what I really am. I'm a purveyor of what's wrong. You guys are wrong. Kevin's a great guy. He's at the end of his career, and you have, and Brent, I hold you responsible for this, and I hope every other citizen in the town does as well.
Yes.
You know the history between Frank,
that's right,
and Brent, Frank and Kevin from Milford. That's right. You know this history. This is just a case of you guys engineering him out of a job to get an extra firefighter. I've never seen anything like this. I never thought we'd ever see anything like this in Litchfield. This is, I mean, everyone here can plainly see it. You guys been papering Kevin for a while. We all know Kevin. We know what's going on. We know when he was getting written up. You know, this is no secret to any of us. Not one of us. And it was like, you put him on administrative leave for a week and you give the guy a choice. He's got a choice of getting fired or taking retirement. That's his choice. That's what he came in with when you guys called him back in for your meeting. I hope you guys just understand how uncharitable you are, really, truly are. And, you know, we had Chaos and Kindness here the other night talking about the love in Litchfield.
No,
get out. It's not even close. I'll tell you, there's, my phone hasn't stopped ringing. People have stopped at my house. I have people that have texted me that want to start a legal fund for him to take you guys to court. I really hope he goes and lawyers up with Joey O'Brien's lawyer and makes you guys miserable for the next 5 years. I really do. Look what you've done. You want to send Kevin at his age to be a firefighter. Y'all know. Why aren't you a firefighter, Brett? Why haven't you been pulling a hose? Because you know somebody over 40 years old has a hard time doing that. Kevin was a fireman. He was a fireman under you. You guys didn't get along. You stuck it to him. And I'm here proud enough to stand up for what I think is right and at least say what's on my mind. Because you don't stand up for anything, you stand up for nothing. So I'm standing up for the little guy again. Just like this thing down here on the farm. It's no one gets up here and talks. No one comes and brings us to your doorstep. But all I am is disappointed. I'm disappointed that you guys would do that. I mean, you could have rode it out a couple of more years if that was your plan, but you would have retired, but you guys have stuck him. So, hallelujah.
Thank you, John Bryant, 16 Arcadian Lane, Litchfield. I just have two things. I know you can't comment personally towards it. I come as a citizen in one place looking and saying, have we made a mistake here in town? We're going to cost the town thousands or millions of dollars in a lawsuit. Have we looked at this clearly from a personnel standpoint of conflict and gone back and said, we've set ourselves up for failure here as a town, and we're going to cost the town taxpayer dollars because someone has been gone and forced into retirement? The second thing I have to say is everything that Kevin brings to town with me as a department head for the Recreation Commission has been tremendous. I've met that man Saturdays, Sundays, everywhere, knowing he's not on the clock. He's always been available. He's been a source for my commission continuously for every year I've been involved. It's been immense for me, and he will be sorely missed, and I don't know how he'll be replaced. and very disappointed in how this is handled in this town. We treat each other better than this, and that didn't happen here.
Thank you, Jim.
As you can see by that video, Ray Peoples and John Bryant were pretty passionate about talking about Kevin Lynch, as they should be. Kevin's a very nice gentleman. And as you know from reading the article, Kevin turned in his letter of resignation to the fire chief. But Brent Lemire, who is the chairman of the Board of Selectmen, explained that long term, the inspection person would also be a firefighter and back up the two current firefighters in an emergency situation. All right. Now, is Kevin suitable to be a firefighter now? I mean, take a look at this, all right? Does he look like he's ready to grab and pull 40 feet of hose to a fire or climb a 50-foot ladder? I don't think so. All right? I wonder why this guy resigned. I would have too. I mean, geez. All right, we're going to take our commercial break. Okay, our sponsors really would like that. And we do have a long list of sponsors. I can tell you that right now. Okay? We had Depends. Remember, we had Depends as one of our major sponsors. All right? And we still have Depends as a sponsor now because we don't have any restroom facilities here still. Okay? All right, next we're going to talk about inspection stickers. We're going to talk about the drive-thru. We're going to talk about luggage. And we're going to talk about taxes. So stay with us.
Warm weather is here and your kids are going to want to keep cool. But if you plan on using a garden hose, be warned. This 9-month-old may look like he has a terrible sunburn, but he was actually scalded when his mom filled a kiddie pool at their home in Arizona. The hose had been sitting in the baking sun for hours. The water inside was super heated. How dangerous can a hose get? This hose was left lying in the California sun for 6 hours. The temperature hit 93 degrees, but when mom of three, Bree Shavers, turned it on, the water was 126 degrees.
In a few seconds, someone could get first or second degree burns.
Riverside County Fire Captain Fernando Herrera gave Bree some good advice.
The first thing you want to do is open up the nozzle, let the water flow for at least a minute, and make sure that the cool water will start running before you fill the pool.
Okay, got it. Oh, that's much cooler.
Another tip, always keep the hose in the shade. That way your kids will be cool in the pool.
Welcome back to In Litchfield. I'm your host, John Latsha. Thank you. Thanks. Hope everybody enjoyed the commercial break. Chance to go to the bathroom. No pun intended. I'm sorry. Okay. Next thing I'd like to talk about is inspection stickers. Okay. Recently, I got my pickup truck inspected, and I don't know about you, but I cannot stand where they put the sticker now, right on the left side of the windshield. All right, why can't they put it over on the passenger side, so when you have a passenger, they can be irritated? Okay, they can get upset. Who cares, right? They're just a passenger. All right, but they have to put it on our side. All right, and it's hard. Maybe it's just because it's a new thing on the windshield now. I'm not used to it. That is a possibility. All right, but my wife told me just don't look at it. You know, every time I have to look at it, you know, here I am driving, like, all right, it's just getting in the way. I feel like just, you know what I feel like doing? I feel like just getting a razor blade, scraping it off, and putting it back under the mirror again. Okay. I'm sure everybody in the whole town of Litchfield feels the same way that I do, all right? In fact, I drive a truck at work, and they have that on the windshield, okay, actually covering one of the mirrors, all right? See, these Einsteins here in Concord, okay, they have no sense of reality, all right? They just make up these laws, and then, you know, I guess they're doing it because the cars, from what I understand, behind the mirror, they're going to be introducing new technology. So, and this sticker up where the rear view mirror is going to impede the signal, I guess, to wherever. I don't know where the signal goes, to Mars, I don't know, Jupiter, who knows. But anyways, now they moved it over to where the driver's side is now, and I can't stand it. In fact, I'm going to write to Concord about this, all right? Because it's Frank Barry, my state representative, all right? If you're watching my program, all right, I want you to make a law, okay, that to bring that sticker back to where it was before, all right? I'm sure everybody in the town of Litchfield is with me on this. In fact, I'm going to add this to my list of aggravating things, all right? Look at my list here again. You know, you saw my list before on these shows, and I'm just going to add this on, okay? Inspection sticker, all right? Okay, now that's on the fifth page of my aggravation list, all right? So we can get that all squared away. All right, next thing I want to talk about is the drive-through, all right? Excuse me, I need a drink of water, right? Whoops. There we go, better. Next thing I want to talk about is the drive-through. And I don't mean a McDonald's or Burger King. I mean down at my local bank. All right, don't laugh, okay? Do not laugh, but I do not have direct deposit. All right, Tony? I do not have direct deposit, okay? I told you before, if you're a loyal viewer of my show, I don't even own a cell phone, all right? Tony, stop laughing. Tony's like in a ball over there, laughing his head off behind the scenes over there, all right? And he's in a soundproof booth over there, so you can't hear him. I can see him, he's rolling around the floor laughing his head off, okay? I'm probably the only person, probably in the United States, that doesn't have a cell phone, all right? But anyways, besides that, the drive-thru. The week prior to me, I go to the bank, I go through the drive-thru because I'm too lazy, I don't want to go in. So I go through the drive-thru, and then I saw this posting up on the window. It said, next week, the drive-thru is going to stop, okay? They're going to eliminate it. You have to come in now. And I'm like, I don't want to get out of the car and come in and wait in line, all that. I just want to sit in my car, you know? So it said at 12 o'clock it closes. Obviously, 12 o'clock, it closes. So what I did was the week after, you know, the next Saturday coming up when they were closing, I got there a little bit early. I got there like 5 minutes to 12, okay? And I waited till about 2 minutes before noon, right? And I went through the drive-thru, okay? I wanted to be the last person to go through the drive-thru at the bank, okay? And here I was. I pulled up to the drive-thru, and I was waiting around. I was expecting people to come out, all right, with balloons, a cake, okay? Some party things, a free, a free vacation or something, all right? This is what I explained to the lady, the teller behind the glass. I go, I thought everybody's gonna come out. I thought I was going to be the special person here, the last one to come through this drive-thru in the 15 years this bank has been here, okay? And I says, where are all my prizes and everything? And all she did was laugh hysterical behind the window, and she just walked away because, the bank was getting ready to close. I'm like, hey, lady, wait a minute here. You got to cash my check, all right? Okay? And so we got all that done. And, I was disappointed, okay? Now, like I said before, I have to get out of the car and I have to walk in, but the problem is every time I walk in, the lady starts laughing every time she sees me, okay? I mean, I don't know why, but probably because she thought I was going to get all these prizes. I said I was going to get all these prizes. Oh, boy, I'll tell you. All right, if you watch the show, if you watch my show a few months ago, I told you that I was going to Atlanta. I was going to my niece's wedding. And some people made fun of my suit. I mentioned my suitcase, and now everybody was making fun of it and everything else. And I'm going to show it to you, okay? I'm going to show you my suitcase. I got it down here under my desk, all right? This is the suitcase that, this is the one that I brought with me, okay? Now, everybody don't laugh, all right? It's an original finesse, okay, by Verdi, whoever that is. All right, and what happened was is when I was going through security, all right, the dog went exactly to where I am. I had to go like this and go, okay, wait a minute. Okay, get away, okay. And the handle's over there pulling him away, okay? Because probably the dog hasn't seen a bag like this ever, all right? The dog didn't see it ever. And the worst part about it is once, you know, 5 minutes or so later while I was waiting in line, he came back again to check up on me, okay, with this bag, okay? You should see me, when this bag was full with all my luggage, I was walking around, you know, around the airport. I kept having to change hands all the time, you know, because everything, you know, my arm was getting real tired and everything while everybody was rolling around with their wheelies, all right? But the most embarrassing part of the whole thing was, you know how when you bring your luggage on the plane and you put it up in the compartment? Well, guess what? I opened the compartment and there was about 50 people behind me waiting to get off the plane. And as I took this out, okay, I took this out and I looked behind me like this, all right? Everybody was smirking, I swear to God. Every single person on that plane was smirking. And then when I got off the plane, the pilot was actually started to laugh. I mean, this is how bad things are. And the worst part about it is my wife actually made me, hey, this is pretty good. My wife actually made me walk through the airport with this thing, okay? So she's got, if you have an updated suitcase or something, okay, could you please send it to me, okay? LATCH2127@AOL.com. So email me and I'll be glad to pick it up. All right? Oh boy, what a day. Hey, I got something to show you here. I got back after a hard day's work, all right, a real hard day at work. And my wife handed me an envelope, and I said, what is this? What's going on with this? She says, open it, and then I'll take your picture. I go, oh, whatever. When I saw the envelope, it said Town of Litchfield on it, all right? So I slowly opened it up, and Tony put up this picture of how I reacted to this, okay? Look at my eyes. They're ready to pop out of my head over there, okay? Because this, I just looked at my tax bill for the year, for the half year, okay? And I was in shock, all right? What I'm going to do is I'm going to send this picture to every single politician that I know, okay? And see the sticker shock that I go through paying taxes, okay? Me and everybody else, all right? I was in shock. I mean, I needed medical attention, I think. As you can see, I mean, what do you think? Oh boy, okay. All right. So, seeing that I don't have any more material left to talk to you about, I think we're gonna end our show. And our next show, I hope we have a guest, okay? I think I'm gonna have a guest. And we'll see. I'm not gonna tell you who it is, but we're gonna have a guest. We're gonna definitely have a guest on our show, all right? So until then, I'm your host, John Latsha, and that's Litchfield. Thank you.
The preceding program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.